Hello students, so today we are going to study about the bacteria structure. If you see, this is the outermost layer of the bacteria, which is known as glycocalyx. And then the next layer is cell wall. So this is bacterial cell wall, and the bacterial cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan. Cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan. Inner to this layer is cell membrane. And see, the cell membrane is making infolding. This infolding is known as mesosome. Another, you are finding infolding, which is having a color. So we call it as chromatophore. So this is your mesosome. And this is your chromatophore. Which are modification of the cell membrane. And this is your cell membrane layer. So in bacteria, all these three layers together are known as cell envelope. We call them as cell envelope. So cell envelope consists of how many layers? It consists of three layers. First is your glycocalyx, then is your cell wall, and third is your cell membrane. All three together are known as cell envelope. First of all, this structure is clear. Now see, inside this, you know very well, this is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is the main area where all the metabolic activities will be performed. So this is known as cytoplasm. Now inside the cytoplasm, you are finding this is double-strand circular DNA. Check the board carefully. This is double-strand. I will use the symbol DS. DS means double-strand circular DNA. It is kept in this position. It is not moving here and there. As a result, we call this place as a nucleoid. We will not use word nucleus. We will say nucleoid. It means it is nucleus-like, but it is not true nucleus. Apart from this, you are finding it is having one additional. This structure is also present. And this structure is known as plasmid, which is extra autonomously self-replicating genetic material. It is not having any membrane-bound organelle, only one organelle which is present in them, that is the ribosome. And ribosome is present, why? Because it is membraneless. So this is the structure of bacteria in which we find they are very simple in structure. Now, very important line of NCERT, we say, bacteria are simple in structure but complex in behavior. So this is the very important line of NCERT, ki bacteria are simple in structure but they are complex in behavior. Now let us study the components of the bacterial cell envelope one by one. First component outside, you know, it is glycocalyx. Glycocalyx, if it is loose, it is known as slime layer. If it is loose, it is known as slime layer. But if it is thick, then we call it as capsule. Now, what is glycocalyx made up of? Glycocalyx is made up of polysaccharide plus D amino acid. It is made up of polysaccharide and D amino acid, and bacteria is pathogenic because of the D amino acid. It is having D amino acid. Next component is cell wall. Cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan, which is also known as murine. Now see peptidoglycan. Try to understand. Name is itself telling it is having peptide bonds. If peptide bonds are present, it means amino acids are there. And glycan means it is a modified sugar. It means it is having carbohydrate. Now which glycan? It is having NAG. NAG means N-acetyl glucosamine and N-acetyl muriamic acid. Because of muriamic acid only, we call this as murine. Is it clear? Because of the muriamic acid, we call bacterial cell wall as murine. Now see how the cell wall is organized. Let us assume this is your NAG. Okay, N-acetyl glucosamine. Another is your NAM, N-acetyl muriamic acid. And in between them, this is your glycosidic bond. Okay, the alternate will be there. Again, NAG, glycosidic bond. Again, NAM and glycosidic bond. This is the way how the sugars are arranged alternately. Now see next here. If suppose here your G is there, then this side will be your NAM. Then NAG. Again, glycosidic bond. So these are the glycosidic bonds which are present in between the sugars. So now see here, the long strips of your modified sugars are arranged with the help of glycosidic bond. Now from the M, means from uramic acid, short tetrapeptide will be hanging. This is the first amino acid, second, third and fourth. So from M only, from uramic acid, the amino acid will be hanging down. Now in between these amino acids, see from here carefully, from the second last, the five amino acid sequence, pentaglycine, there will be pentaglycine, they are attached here. These are five amino acids attached. So these are your glycosidic bond. Green color which I have used is glycosidic bond. And from the M means from uramic acid, this is your short amino acid. Chain of four amino acid is hanging. And this is your linker again with the help of pentaglycine. So this is the structure of your bacterial cell wall, which is made up of peptidoglycan. The third component of the cell envelope is cell membrane. And this is structurally similar to eukaryote. The eukaryote cell membrane, which is made up of phospholipid bilayer, even the prokaryotes are having this membrane. But only one difference you have to just remember. Exception area you have to remember here. Instead of cholesterol, bacterial cell membrane use haplonoids. Otherwise, the bacterial cell membrane structure is similar to that of eukaryotes. Only one difference is there that instead of cholesterol, they make use of haplotes. Now see, next topic is modification of the cell membrane. The first modification is mesosomes. Now see, mesosomes can be in the form of, they can be in the form of tubule, vesicles, and lamella. These are the shapes in which they can be present. Tubule means it can be present this way, vesicle means this way, and if it is this way flat, then we say it is lamella form. So mesosomes can be present in the form of tubules, they can be present in the form of vesicles, they can be present in the form of lamella. So I hope this topic is clear ki in what forms they can be present. Now, types of mesosomes. Types of mesosomes. See, they can be of two types. They can be chondroid, or they can be your septal mesosomes. If you remember mitochondria structure, see here, this is mitochondria. If you know, you have studied in your small classes, this is a double membrane, and inner membrane is thrown into finger-like projections, which you call it as cristae. So in mitochondria, this structure, see this diagram carefully, this structure, this enfolding is known as cristae. Okay. And if you remember bacteria diagram, check my diagram here. Bacteria diagram, if you remember in the we have discussed it, this is a cell wall and this is the cell membrane. The cell membrane is thrown into this way, finger-like projections. So if you see this finger-like projections, isn't it resembling like a mitochondria cristae? Though we call it as mesosome, but it resembles mitochondria cristae. And mitochondria are known as chondriosomes. Mitochondria are also known as chondriosomes. That is why this type of mesosome, which is resembling mitochondria, we call it as chondroid. Because in the previous videos I have discussed oid, whenever word oid come means it is like. It is not true, it is like. So it is mitochondria-like, it is not true mitochondria. Now septal mesosomes. Septal mesosomes will be present in the center and it is responsible for the formation of the septa at the time of cell division. So formation of septa at the time of cell division. So I think so this topic is clear ki there are two types of mesosomes. One is your chondroid mesosomes, another is your septal mesosomes. Chondroid and septal mesosomes. Now see, next is functions of mesosomes. See once again the diagram of bacteria. This is the bacteria cell wall and this is the cell membrane. Which is holding the genetic material. This was the genophore, which was held by the mesosome. If you remember, this was mesosome. And this was your genophore, means nucleoid, which we were calling. So from this, you can make few functions. We can say, first of all, its function is the DNA replication. Because it is holding, so it is helping in DNA replication. After DNA replication, then it will do equal distribution to daughter cells. Equal distribution of DNA to daughter cells. Then if you know, we have already discussed that they are behaving like a mitochondria. The mitochondria means respiration. So respiratory surface. as they are infolding, they are helping increasing the surface area. Then if you know, finally when their DNA replication is done, equal distribution, they will help in the septa wall formation. That is why we say septal mesosome also, the septa formation. And in case of prokaryotes, majority of the ribosomes, see the board carefully, majority of the ribosomes are present on the cell membrane. Here the ribosomes are present. And if they are present on the cell membrane, then you know very well, ribosomes are protein factory. It means ribosomes are helping in making proteins. If they are making proteins, means enzyme, so enzymatic activity. So it is responsible for enzymatic activity, means formation of an enzyme. If it is making enzyme, obviously secretion will also be there. Secretion. So these are the functions of mesosomes. Please learn it properly. And all these are given in your cell chapter, where the prokaryote is mentioned, which is given on the page number 128 and 129. For your reference, I am writing it here. You can check on your page number 128 and 129, which is given in this page number of your 11th class NCERT. So please check it. All these are very important from the need point also. So all the seven functions of mesosomes, I hope this topic is clear to you. Now, next, infolding of the cell membrane is chromatophore. See, first of all, try to learn from the name only. Chroma. Chroma word means color. Chroma word itself indicates ki they are the colored. Okay. So, they are the infoldings which are seen in blue-green algae. They are seen in blue-green algae. And blue-green algae is the one which is going to do oxygenic photosynthesis, which is also known as cyanobacteria. So it is present in the blue-green algae, which is also known as cyanobacteria. So another infolding of the cell membrane. Now see the board. This is the entire summary of the cell membrane. Okay, what are the modifications of the cell membrane? Two modifications. You can see this entire summary on the board right now. Two modifications are there. One is your mesosome, one is your chromatophore. So I hope this topic is clear to you. Thanks for watching class. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel.